Welcome, survivor of the apocalypse. This is Paul Sading, creator of Atheist Apocalypse. I would just like to take a moment to ask you, if you have not already done so, please go over to iTunes, Stitcher, Spreaker, wherever you get this podcast, and give us a great 5-star rating and review. Please help us be found in this vast sea of comedy podcasts. Thank you to those of you who do that for us. We greatly appreciate it. Now, let's get on with the show.
Hi, I'm Armin Navabi from Atheist Republic, and I survived the apocalypse.
Welcome to Atheist Apocalypse, a fictional comedy podcast for Reason. All of the characters you are about to meet are fictional and do not represent real people, except when they do. Either way, we welcome you to the show and would like to encourage you to head over to atheistapocalypse.com for more information about the show, as well as details on how you can contribute to help keep the lights on. After all, this is the apocalypse, and we could definitely use all the help we can get. Thank you!
Welcome, dear Tri-County residents. I'm your anchor, Jake Leminski, along with my ever-dependable yet lower-salaried co-worker, Beatrice Johnson. Welcome, Beatrice. Can you believe we're still broadcasting after all this time?
Not really, Jake, but why would you say that?
Well, people have been calling these mysterious mass disappearances an apocalypse, and that aliens are responsible. As we get closer and closer to the actual answer, I figured they would start interfering more often. I cannot imagine they're happy that we're onto them.
Jake, I'm not sure what you're convinced of, but whatever it is, I'm confident that we're fine. Tyler has doggedly worked all our issues for months now, overcoming some very big obstacles to get us to the stable state we're in. We actually should be grateful. If it wasn't for Tyler...
We might have gotten better coverage of EZQ's announcement last week, where he revealed the truth about the situation.
But the coverage that we did get from Tyler, who, thankfully, is in stable condition at the Hokum General Hospital and 7-Eleven Annex, was enough to convey that what was said at the speaking event was nothing more than speculation and not necessarily something requiring action. Thankfully, most of you gave a moment's pause for a skeptical examination of the statements, but there were a number of Tri-County residents who were stirred into action by the claim that aliens are responsible for these disappearances.
And why shouldn't they? After all, we need to prepare for doomsday. It's not like we can rely on our government to do it for us, even this new, mysterious government entity. So much of their time is already taken up by those hordes of dreadlock hipsters, whining about... whatever latest thing they're upset about. With months of unanswered questions and complete upheaval into how we're governed, is it any wonder that portions of the Tri-County's population would be so reactionary? Though I'll admit, it's odd to see only certain segments of the county reacting with tireless determination to ensure they're prepared for the alien invasion. I'm not quite sure why no one outside of the Estes Estates mobile home park seems to care that they will return for us.
Maybe it's because they're busy scouring the county for any available patchouli products ever since this morning's announcements by the mysterious government entity that this interesting scent is now mandatory for wear. That's right, concerned citizens. If you aren't donning the latest and greatest in patchouli-scented colognes, perfumes, hair conditioners, and genetically modified cucumbers, then you are already out of order and will likely be cited by any of the mysterious government entity misrepresentatives floating around the county's townships. We're not quite sure why patchouli has become the only approved scent for the Tri-Counties, but it's really not our place to question this new government. After all, the latest thing anyone in America should expect of its government, besides action, is reason.
Ignoring your subtle slight against the very entity attempting to provide structure and compliance after this reset of reality, I have to admit that I don't understand this decision either. From everything we've seen, their policies tend to reflect more of a conservative platform. So why patchouli of all scents? It seems incredibly contradictory.
And you wouldn't know anything about being contradictory.
Of course not. I am staunch in the belief that my beliefs are worth believing. I'm sure they have very good reasons to justify what they're doing. They are a conservative government, at least from what we can tell. And that means we should most definitely trust them.
Oh, a moment, please. We have breaking news to bring you. It seems that Mr. Harold Smith and Lansdowne... Jesus, we're really not going to do this dance every time I bring up his name, are we? Easy Q sounds like an ice cream cone.
Not if you choose to respect how he identifies. Until then, I guess you can be prepared for me to confront your bigotry.
What? Are you going to compare a grown man trying to force everyone to refer to him by a childish moniker with the very real struggles that marginalized groups across our community have faced for generations? You know what? Never mind. However you were going to respond probably wouldn't lead anywhere but a lawsuit against the station, and in this post-apocalyptic world, we can hardly afford that. So what we'd like to do now is mention to the listeners the breaking news we have in the aftermath of Smith's comments covered in our last broadcast. If you remember, Smith claimed the disappearances we've experienced were caused by... aliens.
That's correct, B.
Don't call me that.
Easy Q validated his statement with mounds of evidence, all of which pointed to a superior alien race visiting us and taking back with them nearly half the population, which clearly proves just how superior they really are.
While anecdotes serve as excellent content for fireside chats on the long weekend camping trips, it's hardly the stuff evidence is made of. Mr. Smith was arguably entertaining during his proclamation rant on the steps of the park's gazebo, but he didn't actually provide any factual evidence of even the existence of aliens, let alone anything supporting his claim that they visited and kidnapped large numbers of our population.
What about the photographs he put up in his slideshow?
Those were grainy stills shot in the 1950 McMinnville, Oregon sighting, Jake. The long debunked sighting. They were black and white, for God's sakes. Did you not even notice that?
Huh. I figured he was just in a creative mood at the time. Regardless, you, like far too many residents, aren't open to the possibility of alien visitations, so therefore you can't see the evidence, even when it's painfully obvious. You'll regret that when they find you wanting during the invasion.
Well, not everyone in the Tri-Counties will be as unprepared as I apparently will be. Groups across the region are responding to Smith's claims and his presentation of evidence in varying and interesting ways. We're going to bring you more on some of the curious and twisted things your neighbors may be doing in preparations for this visit. But first, as if this were almost scripted, we're turning things over to everyone's favorite meteorologist, Max and Andy, for the weather.
We hate to say we told you so.
We totally told you so. Hashtag sorry dot sorry.
On a related note, Max and Andy's water world is doing quite well. We're working on contacting Skeeticide to lock in a patchouli blend deal with them. We've been wearing patchouli for years for its chakra-enhancing qualities, but it does have other purposes. Apparently the MGE is finally putting its foot down and forcing people to do things they need to do to keep themselves safe.
In the words of the great Ben Franklin, he who would not trade free thought for security deserves neither. The one true ancient American who defied the Freemason Brotherhood of the Serpent. We know you're out there, listening. To you I say, Boaz, Tubalcade. Come at me, bro. We've got your numbers. It all fits together like a puzzle.
Illuminati found it on May 5th, 1776. 5 plus 5 plus 1776 divided by the number 23 conspiracy, add Revelations 3:9 to that, and what do you get? 9-11.
Wake up, sheeple.
Speaking of sheeple, it seems eager patchouli adopters Max and Andy are getting closer to understanding what is actually happening. Way to go, boys. We would also like to announce that Venice Marriott has a new bit-sized segment where she addresses her blog reader questions directly. Take it away, Venice.
Molting buffon. Well, yes, it hurts. But there's really no other way to get it off without seeing a specialist. Hocus pocus talent. I know it said 48 hours in the book, but we are living post-apocalypse. Give it another day, and if she hasn't vanished, try an old folks' home. Cuts down. I haven't tried patchouli on gashes before, but since the MGE is so fond of it, there could be properties we don't know about. Give it a try. But if it blows up for more than 4 hours, please see a doctor, preferably one that specializes in that sort of thing. Anomalous pudding, if you're worried about allergies, ask her what is in the organic coating and tell her why. Maybe if she knows you're asking due to a major breakout, she won't mind telling you what she puts on them. And yes, wash the cucumber before trying again.
I am sure your readers are grateful for that insight, Venice. Thank you. Now that patchouli is the only approved scent, Walmart has begun carrying it. For years, the retail giant had refused to stock patchouli colognes, perfumes, and oils in an effort to keep, and I quote, undesirables out of their stores. Well, now this family-owned, if not family-centric, conglomerate of fundamentalism is reluctantly opening its doors to an entire swath of the Tri-Counties who've never been welcomed before. It sounds like a win for everyone.
Not everyone, Beatrice. I, for one, am not too happy that I'll be spending future trips to my favorite one-stop shopping on the back of lax and nearly non-existent child labor laws institutions, trying to avoid the pungent population who will now be filling the aisles of the company who models what it means to build a fortune on the brand of clothing so low cost that you won't recognize how expensive our food is, just to get my daily sustenance. This is concerning. This is very concerning. What about the rights of those of us who don't consider watercolor painting and playing acoustic guitar in the park a real job?
I cannot wait to see your face when it hits you that the patchouli mandate also applies to you. Either way, ignoring your comments that are consistently inaccurate and hurtful to many listeners, let's break away from this sour story and get over to Venice for the latest installment of her vibrato.
Hello, my lovelies. So many of you have questions for me that I have to send those in separately now. I'm so happy to be able to tune into your auras and vibrations to give you the best advice. Anja said he would help too, so if any of you beautiful little creatures of Gaia want to drop him a line, please do. Horus is being a fright. No, not because he's a ghost, but because he's being insufferable. He is mad that Anja has taken over his side of the bed and has decided to make a federal case of it. I mean, really, it's not like he can actually sleep or anything. So now, even though he was shivering with anticipation to tell me something important, he is refusing to tell me directly and just keeps dropping these infuriating hints. All he will tell me is that he has a new job doing something administrative and is enjoying working with a mysterious group of bureaucrats, whatever that means. He said that he keeps an eye on things for them and gives them advice. Then he just keeps telling me these strange tidbits, almost like poetry. Like he told me that poet is no Smith and the revelation is coming. Horace is very happy with the new patchouli mandate, though. That was always his favorite scent, and he always preferred that I wear it. I'm not sure he can even smell, but he seems thrilled about it. In fact, when the edict came down, he grinned almost manically and said that it was amazing what one could accomplish when you put your non-corporeal mind to it. He's definitely up to something. I think I will see if Cosmia can get anything. She was almost able to see the face of the man who has been staring at her for a while now, and she's determined to find out who it is. I shall keep you all posted. So until next time, my lovelies, remember that the truth is whatever makes you happy, and reality is whatever we believe it to be. Namaste.
And now, your daily monthly movement.
We are some damn sexy people. You should pretty much worship us.
Miss Guy Fox, I'm so sorry.
Oh, that's okay. Poor people always want to be somewhere near a rich person. I mean, I can't blame them. I love smelling like money and...
Oh, tell me all.
And I love sounding like money. Anyways, on to our caller. Are you there?
I make a number of artisanal jams infused with medicinal herbs in an effort to sell them.
Oh, Miss Guy Fox, I heard it's wonderful.
Do you sell them?
I do. I sell them for $55 a jar.
Oh my, oh, yeah, that yeah. sounds...
That's quality,
that
right?
sounds... Yes.
It sounds rich.
Oh my gosh, can you tell me about it?
Oh, certainly. Well, as I was saying, I do have the strawberry massage jam, which I have infused with John's oak bark, good for joints.
Mm. Is it edible?
It is entirely edible. You can put it on sandwiches and also your body, so you can waste it twice as quickly. I've just developed a grape jam, which is infused with banana spider bodies in order to enhance your fertility.
That sounds very exotic.
Yes.
I mean, does it just make you fertile myrtle, or what? What does that do?
Well, I gotta tell you, my wife got near the stuff, and she got pregnant almost immediately.
Oh my gosh.
That just reeks of youth.
Oh, it does. It does.
Yeah, I didn't even have to be involved.
Oh my gosh. I'm so glad you let him on. Thank you so much for calling in. Or do we have any more callers on the line?
I believe so. Let me just switch the line over.
Okay.
Anita,
I am so sorry.
I got the pregnancy test back.
Fox.
You're pregnant with my baby.
Please consider food insurance. Take the pressure off. Know that your family will be safe. Do the easy things now. Call 866-9-GOT-FOOD.
Okay,
The reason you're craving jam is because you're pregnant with my baby.
That is going to be...
As the emissary of the devil, a closet homosexual, you need to understand.
I've lost my mind. I'm a fool. I hate black folk. I'm not down with the in crowd. Nobody would love me. Black people, I'm gonna deliver you. Pregnant with my baby.
Okay,
can you tell that woman to stop humming into the microphone? Damn ears. I'll call you on your cell.
You know what? I think that's good for today. Ian, why don't you take us out?
I don't make as much money as you. Okay, and that was it.
We're finding good help.
Oh, hell. So sorry. And that's it for our daily monthly movement.
Jesus.
And now, our weekly religious segment with Pastor Roy. Why the hell are all these pastors named Roy? Was Roy in the Bible?
Hey folks, this is Pastor Roy. Anyway, there's a lot of people freaking out, just ringing my cell phone and just burning up a minute. So I'd rather you just drop by the trailer. I'm a lot three now, so just drop by. And I know there's a lot of hubbub about a lot of people being gone about alien abductions. And it's not an alien abduction, otherwise you wouldn't find their underwears everywhere. And that's why there's lots of underwears left and shoes and socks and pants and dresses and stuff, because everybody just left, because they leave naked. Because you don't even think about sex in heaven, you don't even think about it. So everybody leaves naked, just like you come in, you go out. I did talk to Jesus, because I was a little worried. I was, because, I mean, half the congregation was gone. And I was a little worried, and Miss Maribel's kitty cats not being fed. So I was having to feed them, too. And that costs extra money. And Medicare doesn't cover that. They just don't cover it. So the bottom line is, so I talked to Jesus. I rung him up and said, Jesus, what's going on? And he said, well, it's a rapture. Don't panic, because I left you because you're the America's true pastor. You're the only one that's called a God. And so That's why he left me to direct people. This is important. This is something you put your think caps on. Jesus says that it's not aliens. That's the evil evil dictatorships. They're trying to make you think that this is just normal, just everyday run of the mill aliens. It's not aliens. He took all the important people except for me because he said I needed a lead and guide people. And that's why I'm here. A lead and guide you. You'd show up Sunday church and there'd be nobody there. And there's about 613 scriptures that's a book of laws that things that you ain't supposed to do. And some of those you may be doing. And Jesus gets mad even if you're ignorant too, because he's got a book. He's had a book for 2,000 years or so. And there's lots of people just say, no, I couldn't wear cotton with polyester. And see, this is why you'll see me in the polyester suits. The whole suit's polyester. Even my underwear is polyester. So what I'd like you to know is don't panic. Don't panic and I've gotten several of you just calling about all this new rule about the scents, about the toilet water, and that's patchouli, and it's official scent of the nation. That's what they're saying, and that's the government. It's a little plant, smells like mints, and it's not bad for you. It won't hurt you. It's actually good for you. It makes you live forever. Well, not forever. It'll make you live a lot. It cures cancer. Just take it. Get rid of your brute, because that's not going to cut it, because they're wanting everybody to smell the same. So be sure to check that out. Be sure to get you the patchouli toilet waters and splash it on. Don't panic. I'll see you Sunday. I'm going to have more information Sunday at church, and that's right here at the church at Catfish Creek First Baptist Church. You be sure to be there because you don't want to be squared. I love you. Jesus loves you too. Jesus told me to tell you not to panic. Don't panic because your friends and stuff's gone. Don't worry. They're happy.
And staying with our correspondents, Kelly Muttersee has been bringing stories from far and wide to listeners of the Tri-Counties, and tonight is no different. What do you have for us, Kelly?
Yes, thanks, Jake and Beatrice. It's me, Kelly Muttersee. Welcome to Enter the Swag Man. First of all, I heard about this new mandate that everybody has to make themselves go out and smell like patchouli. My first question was, what the bloody hell is patchouli? And I discovered that it was a scent that makes you smell like an old hippie, but not the sort that makes you smell like old bong water, which made me happy because I do reek of old bong water. Now when I put on my patchouli scent and when I walk down the street, I smell just the same as everyone else. I don't sound just the same as everyone else. That's almost what I said, partially because I smell like bong water. But anyway, I am not opposed to this new patchouli scent, and I don't talk like anyone else but me. And also, thank you to all of the lovely birthday presents that people sent me this week. Like the antique game of Pac-Man, the standing console, that was a pretty bloody good present. You're a dickhead, whoever got me that, you're a dickhead, because now I'm in your favour. I'm in your favour. That other game you gave me, the Maniac one, Pac-Man and the Maniac game, they're bloody excellent, and you're a dickhead, whoever got me that, because I'm never going to be able to get you back a present as good as you got me. I'm going to go and probably smell more like bong water and then even more like patchouli. So anyway, thanks all, and keep listening to... I didn't say anything of substance at all. Just nothing. I'm floating around in my blimp, and I don't know what the bloody hell's going on. My Wi-Fi went out, my Wi-Fi, as I like to call it, except I had a Wi-Fi one time. She went to get a pack of cigarettes, and then she came back with a divorce, and I didn't even get any cigarettes, so now I call it Wi-Fi like I'm supposed to. Anyway, back to you guys.
Always a good time with Kelly.
If there's one thing Kelly likes besides cocaine, it's a good time. Either way, Beatrice, now is not the time for good times discussions. It's more appropriate to be talking about end times, if anything. Thankfully, we have our local churches to lean on in times of desperation. This morning, Beaverlick Baptist over in Winkieville announced that they were holding a toy drive in response to EZQ's announcement. Pastor Roy Jacobs proudly declared the church's initiative to his growing congregation this Sunday, and within 2 days, the congregation responded by providing thousands of toys for those around the Tri-Counties.
I'm not sure just how a toy drive helps prepare for an alien invasion, Jake. I mean, you'd think things like spider-free water and non-perishable foods would be at the top of the list, not toys.
See? This just shows how out of touch you are. You didn't even mention tinfoil. Amazing. In this day and age, when you have so much information at your fingertips, you choose to remain ignorant. On a more positive note, our favorite business insider, Nellie Negapositv, has jumped in to help the community out once again. We have her on the line with us now. Welcome, Ms. Negapositv.
Well, hello there.
It's been a while since you've joined us. And actually, as a new Jake, you and I have never even met. Though I've heard wonderful things about you from old Jake. You know, before he was kidnapped.
Well, yes. I do miss old Jake, and I hope everything is okay with him. He was such a stimulating man.
Well, I promise to be just as stimulated. Ing. Stimulating.
Right. We'll see.
Ms. Negapositv. You've been at the forefront of most revolutionary thoughts in the Tri-Counties during not only your time as a resident, but also as a business owner and Chamber of Commerce president. Now you're taking the lead as a philanthropist. As if you didn't have enough on your plate, what made you decide to get involved in the Doomsday preparations?
Oh, you are just adorable, new Jake. I had heard about the efforts of Pastor Jacob through an associate. I guess you could say, and I wanted to ensure that Bittersweet had a place within his project, especially since so many of my faithful customers are also members of his congregation.
How wonderful! The good pastor must have been surprised and amazed that you wanted to join the effort, was he not?
Actually, the pastor and I had some long talks spanning well into the early morning hours, and on more than a few occasions, about what he wanted to do and how I could help. This wasn't an off-the-cuff reaction on Roy's part. He's been thinking about this for a long time, almost since the beginning of the disappearances. We put a lot of effort into this, and there was a lot of back and forth between us during the session. And we continue to do a lot of long, hard negotiations. We really grind it out.
Well, that sounds incredibly reproductive. Productive. Productive. The public is curious. What are you bringing to this heartwarming campaign sponsored by Beaver Lick Baptist?
Well, my special cucumbers won't hold up in the weather this time of year, especially with it being all wet. Any dust in the air will just clump to those cucumbers. I've sent over a few hundred variety boxes of my special latex rubber stress relievers. I know a few ladies in the congregation. My apologies. I know most of the ladies in the congregation, and they're quite familiar with that particular product line. You can just imagine how thrilled they were to receive them.
Yes. Yes, I am. I can.
Okay, sorry to have to interrupt this segment, but something actually important is happening in the sports department. Let's get you over to Artie now.
Hello, everybody. My name is Bill. I know what you're going to say. Where's Artie? We need to be hip with the sports news and with the goings-on with the sports ball. But my dear friend Artie asked me to cover for him tonight. What he's doing is none of my business. So I'd like to tell you about my new business, Will's Wine and Bistro. We don't do the bistro part yet, but we do have the chocolate cake. We got the wine. We got a big selection, and it's very impressive. So, ladies half off. Drinks are half off. This week we got the platypus wine, the platypussies, platypi wine. How do you say it? It's platypi wine. Okay. Now, what are you going to do? Is you going to come in, you're going to take a seat at the bar like doobity-doo. Then you're going to say hello, and I'm going to personally pour you a glass of wine. There. It's going to be a head wine, pay no mind. I just like it that way because it gives me the wibbly wobblies. Okay, you see, we have a lot of plush couches. They can be curled off for private engagements. Lots of entertainment too. A jukebox, so you can do the booping with the bopping, and even the air hockey table. We have weekly tournaments. Tonight, you should come. I name all the teams. Tonight, it's the Phil Flyer Phil versus the Squizzly False Accusation. Okay, and I'm done talking about it. Now I'm off for some exploration, Rudy. Come on down. Okay, we're done.
We broke away for that. Well, while we're on the topic of sponsors, this broadcast was brought to you by Porta Punish. Does boredom strike you while you're riding the city bus on your way to work? How about sitting in the doctor's office 15 minutes early to your appointment, which won't even begin until 35 minutes after it's scheduled? In these moments, do you find yourself thinking, I could definitely go for some self-flagellation, but you forgot your whip at home? Fear the wrath of your watchful overlord no more. Porta Punish has a solution for you. Whip it good with our super compact mobile mutilator. It fits right in your pocket. For just 16 relatively convenient payments of $19.99, plus shipping and handling, you'll be ready to whip the sin right out of you no matter where you are. And, as a one-time special offer, you can get our bonus evil extractor for the wicked low price of $59.96, patent pending. That whip just not punishing you enough? Use our evil extractor as your one insertion solution and just pull the sin right out. Never be unprepared again. Porta Punish. Because nothing says I hate myself and want the world to know it like mutilating your body on public transit. And now we take you over to our man with the plan for salvation, Rick Beckley.
I don't like this new world. It reminds me of that Stephen King apocalypse novel.
Cell?
No.
The Stand?
No.
Well, that is all...
Mad Max.
Why am I not surprised?
Sarah, I'm gonna break into City Hall.
You're gonna do what?
You heard me. I'm gonna find a way to sneak into City Hall and find out exactly what the mysterious government entity really has to say about these disappearances. They have to know something.
Why, Rick Beckley, are you actually starting to act like a reporter?
I am a reporter, and I always get the story.
Since when exactly? The last time you got close to people involved in the mysterious government entity, you pulled the plug off your mic and lost the story of the century. Or maybe forever, as far as the Tri-Counties is concerned.
Hey, I got the story, didn't I? It's not my fault you failed to fulfill your responsibilities as a producer.
Whoa, wait a second. You do remember how all that unfolded, don't you?
Anyways, I'm pretty sure we can get through that third story window up there. It looks unlocked.
Really? And what does an unlocked window look like?
Like that. I guess. I think we can shimmy up that drain pipe.
Rick.
I just need you to give me a boost.
Rick, get your foot off my hand. I'm not gonna try and lift you. Ow, that hurts. Get down. Listen, I have an idea.
What? Huh? What can you possibly want that's more important than getting inside this building?
Why don't we just go through the front door?
Sarah, the mysterious government entity is in there, making all kinds of top-secret plans. What in the world would make you think they would leave the front door unlocked?
Well, besides the fact that it's wide open?
Yes, besides... What?
Yeah, it's wide open.
Well then, let's get inside and find out what they know.
So we're really gonna do this?
Yes. It's something we have to do, like washing your hands after using the bathroom, or using a turn signal when you're switching lanes, or putting soy sauce on your reheated spaghetti.
Ew, what?
Hey, don't knock until you try it.
Whatever. Let's get in there then.
Follow me, Sarah. We're about to make history in the present.
Idiot.
Wait, stop.
What?
There's a note on the door. Let's see. To whom it may concern, we, the mysterious government entity, are remaining neutral as to whether or not these alien abductions are responsible for the mass disappearances. Well, there you have it. Rick Beckley gets a story again. Boom.
Are you kidding me? That's it? All that build-up for this?
It's our government. Why would they lie? Anyways, this has been Rick Beckley, KUSA 9, News at 9. Saving the world, one story at a time. back to the studio.
Just stellar, stellar work again, Rick. Glad to see you're finally getting that intern of yours up to speed.
She has a name.
Okay, that's adorable. Anyway.
Hello, this is Martha Stewart. I've had the opportunity to offer you many tips in my monthly edition of Cornerstone. Now I'm pleased to present my new Martha Stewart line of bedroom clothing. I'll find the domestics department and see this exciting collection for yourself. It's the first of many things to come, and I think you'll be as thrilled about it as I am. Come pick up my latest edition of Cornerstone and domestics for the kitchen corner. I have some new tips I can't wait to share with you.
Between Tyler and intern Sarah, we're getting very close to finding out the source of these interruptions. They've become so commonplace that we hardly notice them anymore, which probably doesn't make those responsible for their broadcasting very happy. But we're not talking about social justice warriors here. If the source behind these mysterious messages wants to communicate with us, they're going to need to learn to meet us halfway. Intern Sarah and Tyler, once he's back on his feet, will continue to do what they can to identify the source and attempt to prevent them from interrupting our broadcasts.
Until that time comes, and I'm hedging my bets that it never will, we're going to keep on trucking with business as usual. Like all good Americans, we know true joy in life comes from slaving away, day in, day out, missing all of our limited existence's inherent joys and beauty in order to make the next sale or address the next customer's first world needs.
And on that note, it appears the retailers and grocery outlets around the Tri-Counties are complying reluctantly with the patchouli mandate. Hipsters in towns across the counties are thrilled to finally have access to their preferred scent, and bus stops, coffee shops, and street corners are now filled with the minty freshness of far-off forests no one in the Tri-Counties could ever hope to visit. We could focus on the fact that some retailers are shoving their displays of the required scent into the back corners of their stores, away from their main shopping areas, segregating traditional patchouli patrons from the more conservative population, but we're going to stay focused on the positives in the story.
That's right, Beatrice. We may now all smell the same, but with enough exposure, we'll soon no longer notice. And isn't that yet another shining example of the mysterious government entity's exquisite plan? Erasing variations? We are yet one step closer to having a truly homogeneous society. And isn't that what those pesky progressives have been demanding for years? Well, they're getting closer to what they asked for. I hope they're happy.
Right. Well, there are some folks who aren't too happy right about now, and I'm talking about groups of scientists, astronomers, and secular science meetup organizations around the Tri-Counties. They've been anxiously waiting for a further public address from the mysterious government entity. So far, they only have deafening silence in response to Harold Smith's alien abduction proclamation. These groups aren't exactly thrilled about the MGE's lack of social presence.
That's right, Beatrice. We've sent numerous requests through the Golden Foghorn on Pier 13 and still have not heard back regarding their official position. If I was the kind of guy to jump the shark gun, I'd be halfway to my desert underground bunker and armory right now. But I'm not. I'm sure our righteous MGE is working feverishly on a plan to defend us from the impending alien invasion.
Or it could be that the shadowy figures responsible for running our government day to day are actually busy governing as opposed to chasing pop culture baloney. Local religious organizations are definitely not idly standing by, however. They have been among the most active in the area when it comes to responding to the non-response of the MGE.
Indeed. I'm happy to announce that my own church, St. Anglican of Righteous Wisdom, is holding a clothing drive this weekend to help prepare those blessed souls for the visit who don't own proper attire. Most items will be accepted, especially silk ties, full Armani suits, and coach purses. However, please refrain from donating fedoras and trilbies, as we still have quite an abundance left over from our last clothing drive.
Wow, Jake! Vexing materialism aside, that's That's really awesome of your church. In this day and age, with so many strange things going on and no clear vision of what the future will be like, taking time to stop and serve humankind, especially the less fortunate, is remarkably refreshing. I've got to hand it to your church leaders. It's inspiring. Maybe we should do a story on them.
Who said anything about helping the less fortunate? We're not interested in those lazy sacks. We put so much effort into these drives, we don't need leeches sucking from the teat of the church. We get results. Recently, we hosted a fundraiser directly outside Wingo County's Soup Line and Shelter during their quarterly Feeding Our Community event. We raised thousands that evening and reinvested that into ensuring our congregation is ready for when our new overlords arrive.
You sniped profits from another charity event? You cannot be serious.
Oh, I am. We're pretty proud of ourselves, and of course, the Tri-County community for being so supportive. The public's money went into the right accounts that day. It's absolutely amazing how deep people will reach into their pockets when they believe in a cause.
We're misled by shyster practices.
Unfortunately, we've run out of time this evening. We hope that more organizations will follow the lead of the Tri-County churches, like my own, and walk the path the righteous have carved for them. In a world decimated by disappearances, selfishness, and greed, it is good to see so many members of a community come together to make life just a little bit better, for at least a few select people. That more of us behave so nobly is this reporter's hope. We can only hope that by highlighting the actions of the good people of the Tri-Counties through our stellar reporting, we will not only encourage others around the Tri-Counties to care and give thanks in this season of Thanksgiving, but also perhaps encourage those who govern us to lead us. This is a time for leadership, a time for a leader. But will anyone step up to lead a leaderless world? Listeners, we may not get that answer anytime soon, but I encourage you, stay calm, and calm we shall stay.
The Atheist Apocalypse podcast is a pulsating production. You can find more information at www.atheistapocalypse.com. Today's episode was written and edited by Paul Sading, Brian Bristol, Jay Crawford, Deborah McTaggart, Nick Morganmore, Jeff Venutsis, and Dan Kukola. It was produced by Brian Bristol. Music was created by Jason Kamo and Kenechi Ohm. All artwork you can enjoy on our YouTube channel was created by Lucy D. The voice of Venice was Donna Shell. The voice of Nellie is Maddie Sading. All advertiser memes created by Nancy Drew. This episode included a special Porta Punish sponsorship message created by Roxanne Stevens and Nancy Drew. Thank you for being the first listener contribution to the show. If you, like Benny Baker, would like to write into the studio and have a word at Jake or Beatrice, you can feel free to write us at atheistapocalypsepodcast@gmail.com. Be sure to like us on Facebook at facebook.com/atheistapocalypsepodcast. And follow us on Twitter at @AApodcastShow. If you enjoy our show and want to motivate us to keep doing more, please visit our Patreon page at patreon.com/atheistapocalypse. We here at Atheist Apocalypse will talk to you again after Thanksgiving dinner. We will all be much fatter. Just so very, very fat. It'll be glorious. We would like to thank each and every one of you who supports the show to keep it alive and well, which is more than we can say about this post-apocalyptic world we've created for you. Oh, and this turkey. Come here, turkey. Come here. Yeah, you'll do just fine.